Suppose you find yourself on the edge of a vast desert, and with you have an impossibly reliable Jeep and an infinite source of fuel. But the Jeep can only hold one unit of fuel, and with that fuel it can go exactly one unit of distance. Furthermore, at any point in the desert you can store fuel from your Jeep for later use. How far in the desert could you go and still return? Naturally, one might say, well, I can go half of my fuel away and then spend the rest to return. But that's not very interesting. What about our ability to leave fuel in the desert? Say we drive 1/4 of our capacity outward, store half of our fuel, and then we have 1/4 of our fuel left, exactly enough to get us back to base. Well, we're out of fuel now, but luckily we have our unbounded source of fuel and we can fill back up. This is an interesting position because we have a full tank of gas and more waiting for us in the desert. So we drive our quarter distance out, take one of the 1/4 from the pile to fill us back up, and then we can drive our 1/2 distance outward and return back. We're out of fuel, but we're at the first drop off, which holds exactly enough to get us back home. Now we've gone farther than our initial 1/2 distance by an additional 1/4. This algorithm for leaving fuel can be generalized, and how far we go really depends on exactly how many trips we're willing to take. For example, say we want to go 5 trips, leaving exactly enough fuel at very precise increments so that we have enough to return to base and refuel. How far would we have gone? In this example, we end up traveling 1/10, 1/8, 1/6, 1/4, and 1/2. If we count the return trip, our total distance on the last trip is twice these values, and this adds up to be 1/5, 1/4, 1/3, 1/2, and 1. This series is called the Harmonic Series, and we've traveled exactly half of the fifth harmonic number. So asking how far we can travel outward is equivalent to asking how large does this number actually get? Well, through a method called Cauchy condensation, we can compare this series to a smaller series. And in our case, the smaller series diverges, meaning that by comparison, the harmonic series must diverge, or this number goes to infinity. This implies that we can go any distance if we're willing to make enough trips. But how many trips are we talking about here? Well, if we look at the function that generates the harmonic sequence, through the eyes of integral calculus, we can make some pretty decent approximations. The area under the curve of 1 over x is known to be the natural log of x. So asking what arguments for the natural logarithm gives us our desired distance will give us our estimation. And as we can see here, if we want to go one unit of distance, it'll take about 7 trips. But if we wanted to go, say, 10 units of distance, we can see this value grows exponentially, taking more than 485 million trips.